Here is quality versus greed. So that is what exactly whoever will understand what is difference in quality and what is difference in greed. So quality is the degree to which the product meets the customer or end user. And here, meets the customer or end user requirements, guys. Okay. It is not talking about any standard, any documents, any ISO. That is, ISO is their own. They have created the standard, a guidelines as per your organizational requirements. You can take references from those ISO standard and create your own product or project requirements. Okay. Just have to take the reference from those standard. It does not mean ISO exactly will be applying in every project. In every project means Samir project, Ajmi project, Surya project. No, ISO does not mean will be applying blindly and it is mandatory to apply. It is a guideline. It is a reference point. Your organization going to take the reference of ISO. Based on that, they will create their own quality management system, incorporating client requirements, and that will follow in your project. Moving ahead here, now difference we were discussing here, customer or end user requirements. Okay, quality is degree to which the product meets the customer or end user requirements. Whereas grade is a category assigned to products that have the same functional use but different technical characteristics. High grade does not imply high quality, while having low quality is always a problem. Having a low grade may not be a problem.
Samir, required example over here. High grade does not imply high quality, or low grade may not be a problem.
Okay.
Maybe I can explain, Samir, if you don't mind.
Yes, sure. Go ahead. Just I wanted to know how many of you got understanding.
Okay, just to make simple, I don't know if it helps. If I give example of Apple phone and Vivo phone, Apple phone quality is good, but the features great, maybe not good as Vivo, like sensors, many other features what Vivo has it. But Vivo quality is less, but they have more grades. So that means if customer wants good quality, so he prefers Apple than Vivo phone. That's my understanding. Is okay. It right?
Exactly right for me.
My question is, who determines the grade? Because if you are using the example of Apple and the other brand that you mentioned, who determines grade? Because that other brand may just be what quality is for me, the user, right? So when you say quality versus grade, I don't understand it yet, because ordinarily I would imagine that the high grade equals high quality and low grade equals low quality. So that's my own way of, you know, the normal, what I would ordinarily
normal think. Understand.
Yes. So I'm not quite, I don't understand your explanation of this yet, please.
All right. We all are here to understand.
Can I say something here, Samir?
Yes, go ahead.
So, for example, I have to use steel in my civil works. Now, this steel, there will be a grade required as per the contract that the customer specifies. Okay, so we have to meet that particular grade requirement, and if we meet, then it is a good quality. If we go for a higher grade, it means technically you have a better characteristic. But it does not, it not necessarily mean that you are meeting the quality because you are going for a higher grade. But if suppose some constraints are there in the project and you have to go for a higher grade in agreement with the customer, then you are still meeting the quality objectives of the project.
Yes, I also just, Samir, I want to speak to the concern with same as me.
Speak up, sir,
I'm just come on that same point what Mr. Dair is saying. That one of that project that we have, our requirement was Fe 500D steel, right? But we have that grade of steel now, it is not available. So we have go for higher grade. In concern with that rates and all that, concern with the client and all. So in that case, we are going for higher grade and meeting with the characteristics higher always. And quality wise also it is good. So in that case, if you are going, then we are going for higher grade and we are maintaining quality also good. Because quality after all, if you go for higher grade, then the quality is always good. So in that case, this will not work out. But as you say that having a low grade may not be a problem. So we are going for higher grade and quality also we are matching.
Yeah. So let's take one example.
Just want to add on my example. Maybe Fumi can understand. Suppose the end user is your grandmother and she wants to use a phone. And she just wants to use a phone to call someone. Her requirement only to get a phone with number pads, then she can use easily. But if you give her a touch phone, it suffices the requirement, what she wants, but it's difficult for her to operate the phone.
So
the quality is good, but the grade is so high, end user is not happy with that. That is my opinion as
very
well.
Very good example.
So, I believe quality is more subjective, whereas grade is more objective, because grade we associate with technical characteristics.
Correct.
Quality is subjective. I mean, like, for example, if I want just, let's say, a side give example of having a phone. So the requirement is only having a phone. Doesn't matter the grade, right? So quality is subjective. Sometimes we misunderstood between quality and meeting quality and meeting specifications, right? You can specify something and then it must meet the technical specification. It doesn't mean that it's a high quality. It can be low quality or high quality, but it must, it's different from, you know, meeting the specification. So quality is subjective, whereas grade is objective.
Great. Let's conclude this conversation. Let's take one example. Example adjective same. I'm going to elaborate, which has been given by the Saeed. Like, let's say you are buying a basic phone. Basic phone is something to make a call, okay? And normal storage capacity for having some folders, okay? So that is what you are buying, right? That is a cell phone, which you can say that low grade because it is with high features. So you are buying the low grade cell phone. This is the like basic model, right? And it is working well without any issues, without any problem, without any defects. It is working fine. Since you have paid less amount, you have purchased the basic model phone. You are not expecting from this mobile to work for the Wi-Fi, to give you the face detector, to give you high storage. You are not expecting it because you have paid a minimal amount and you bought a basic phone. But here what you have to pay attention is, it is working fine. There is no defects. There is no trouble and no problem at all. So this is the first case where you are buying the basic phone. Now the second case is, you are buying advanced feature mobile. Let's say Apple advanced, latest mobile, right? So that latest mobile, you have paid good amount to buy that mobile, and you are expecting to work smoothly, give you higher storage, working with Wi-Fi, give you camera, also give you the face detection. It's all the features which has been immobile should be working flawlessly. This is what you are expecting, but it is giving you trouble. It is giving you a problem. It is not working smoothly. Though this is high grade mobile, but it is not working smoothly, flawlessly, giving you trouble. It is low quality. In the first case, you have paid for basic mobile and you were happy with that because it was working flawlessly without any trouble, without any problem. So though it was low grade, but meeting your requirements. So that is high quality. So this is what you have to understand. And this is the last line you have to read, like having low quality is always a problem. Means the Apple phone which you have bought, expecting every features will work smoothly, but it was started giving you a problem. So there is quality issue. Though it is high grade, but there is a quality issue. So having a low grade may not be a problem. Having a low grade may not be a problem. This is applicable for the basic phone, which I have told you, you bought low grade phone, but it was keeping you satisfied and happy. So this is the difference between quality and grade. I hope everyone can understand it now.